Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Enggal Suhayuni. Now I'm gonna explain about segmenting, targeting, and positioning. So for the first, I wanna tell you a little story about China. So in this slide, that the point that I can tell you is in China, so many world people, and in China also there is pembagian dua daerah, jadi kayak the first tier kayak Shanghai, Shenzhen and Beijing, and the second tier is yang beberapa di China yang lebih pedalaman. Nah, kalian bisa lihat di sini. And in the second tier cities di China itu, so many Chinese there that purchasing French wine, Italian designer clothes, and German luxury cars. Nah, dari situ kan kita bisa lihat tuh kalau China itu negara yang banyak orang kaya tuh. Terus gimana caranya biar kita bisa connect ke mereka, berhubungan dengan mereka? So the effort by global companies to connect with wealthy Chinese consumer is highlight the importance of skillful global market segmentation and targeting. In here, I want a little explain about what is market segmentation, what is targeting, and what is positioning. So the first is market segmentation. Based on my PPT that yang aku ambil ilmunya dari buku, segmentation is represent an effort to identify and categorize group of customer and countries according to common characteristic. So dari based on apa cerita sebelumnya, slide sebelumnya, aku cerita tentang Cina yang mereka tuh banyak orang kayanya, banyak milioner dan billionaires. Sudah di situ kita bisa bikin segmentation di Cina. Misalnya kamu adalah example, you wine producer. Jadi orang apa pebisnis wine gitu kan, atau pengusaha yang menghasilkan memproduksi wine. Nah, kalian bisa segmentationin Cina ini sebagai negara yang kalian segmen buat jual produk kalian. But there is still apa, ada targeting. Nah, targeting is the process of evaluating the segment and focusing the market effort on a country, region, or groups of people that has significant potential to respond. Nah, dari yang Cina tadi kita segmenin sebagai apa tuh namanya, segmentation, market segmentation kita sebagai pengusaha wine gitu kan. Nah, di targeting ini kita lebih focusing lagi, we have to more specific again dengan kita evaluasi seperti yang dicerita tadi kan. Di second tier-nya itu kan banyak dari warganya yang membeli, yang purchasing apa, wine, French wine kan. Mereka suka wine, French wine. Nah, kita bisa lebih focusing lagi, berarti market segment kita tuh di Cina, dan kita targetingnya ke second tier-nya, daerah di second tier-nya yang lebih pedalaman, yang ternyata suka membeli wine. Even itu mereka membeli wine-nya di wine-wine dari French. And then positioning. Positioning is required to differentiate the product or brand in the minds of target customer. Jadi setelah kalian nentuin market segmennya, targetingnya, nah di situ kalian harus posisiin produk kalian supaya bisa bersaing dari pesaing kalian. Misalnya kayak tadi tuh, mereka suka beli yang French wine. Kenapa sih? Nah, kalian tuh harus cari tahu dan memposisikan kayak produk kalian sesuai based on your marketing, market segmentation and targeting, yang targetingnya itu. Nah, setahu saya untuk penjelasan tentang market segmentation, targeting dan positioning itu kayak gitu. Oke. For the next slide is global market segmentation. You can read for the detail. Jadi for global market segmentation itu di sini ada dua penjelasan short explanation. Ya, global market segmentation has been defined as process of identifying specific segment, whether they be country, groups or individual. Jadi kayak misalnya di negara, misalnya lagi nih, bukan cuma di Cina tuh. Misalnya lagi kamu tuh seorang penjual apa ya? Ke misalnya, nah, skincare tuh. Skincare itu kan kalian tahu tuh di Korea tuh banyak skincare yang bagus. There's so many good apa quality of skincare from Korea, right? And then kalian bisa ambil dari sana tuh ininya apa produknya, then kalian jual ke kira-kira yang negara mana yang kira-kira bisa tuh dipasarin apa namanya skincare dari Korea. Oh, misalnya Indonesia contohnya, misalnya nih ya. Karena apa misalnya? Indonesia is one of country yang banyak tahu tentang drama Korea, tentang K-pop di sana, terus jadi kayak keikut budayanya, terus kayak kalau di beberapa drama-drama Korea kan nunjukin skincare Korea gitu juga bagus-bagus kan. Nah, habis itu jadi orang Indonesia nih jadi kayak kepengen gitu. Nah, kalian bisa tuh segmentin market segmentation di global itu Indonesia salah satunya. Karena Indonesia juga masuk ekonomi ASEAN kan, yang perdagangannya kalau sama Korea juga masih bisa kan, masih aman gitu. Nah, bisa berhubungan gitu kan. Nah, bisa tuh jadi Indonesia jadi segmentation-nya. Nah, itu nanti ditargeting lagi, difokusin lagi juga bisa. Nah, untuk yang penjelasan kedua nih, marketing practitioners and apa academic have been interested in global marketing for several decades. Nah, ini bisa kalian baca sendiri untuk penjelasannya. Oke, terus global market segmentation itu juga ada demographic segmentation. Nah, di demographic segmentation ini, based on measurable characteristic of population such as income, population, age distribution, gender, education and occupation. A number of global demographic trend favor married couples, smaller family size, changing roles of women, higher incomes and living standards, and for example have contributed to the emergence of global market segments. Jadi tuh di demographic segmentation ini, as I know, dia lebih ke segmennya tuh based on ini, kayak income-nya, pendapatannya, age distribution-nya, gender-nya, education, dan pekerjaannya, seperti itu. Oke, okay. Next is psychographic segmentation. I don't know like the detail of psychographic segmentation ini ya. Tapi aku berusaha jelasin ke kalian based on the books. Jadi semua ini aku ambil dari buku. Yang aku presentasiin di sini tentang psychographic segmentation itu ya ini, involves grouping people in terms of their attitudes, value and lifestyle. Itu agak tipu. Data are obtained from questionnaire that require respondent to indicate the extent to which they agree or disagree with a series of the statement. And you can see more for the detail. I can explain more because honestly I don't really understand about this part. Maybe we can ask Mam Indah to explain. And there is a behavior segmentation. Behavior segmentation focus on whether people buy and use a product, as well as how often and how much they use or consume. Jadi itu ini tuh based on our behavior ya. Jadi misal kebiasaan, kalau kita mau lihat di global market, global marketnya sendiri, misalnya nih, kita tuh seorang pengusaha kayak apa tuh namanya, yang peralatan untuk bangun rumah gitu kan, kayak ada jual keran, ada jual bak mandi, ada apa-apa gitu-gitu. Nah, terus kita pengen segmentation ini, kayak misalnya di mana sih kayak yang negara yang buat aku kasih misalnya nih semprotan air di kamar mandi. Nah, nggak mungkin kan kita jual ke kayak negara Amerika dan lain-lain itu, karena di Amerika mereka membasuh kayak BAB atau apa, mereka tuh pakai tisu, bukan pakai semprotan air yang kayak keran itu. Nah, kalau mau yang jualin yang itu, otomatis kita harus ke ini, apa tuh namanya, ke negara yang menggunakannya, seperti misalnya Indonesia. Nah, bisa tuh behaviornya kayak gitu kan, mereka pakai itu kebiasaan, dan kita bisa jualin itu ke Indonesia, bisa segmentationin di Indonesia based on the behavior. Terus apa nih, benefit segmentation. Benefit segmentation is global benefit segmentation focus on the numerator of the value equation. Nah, ini ada rumusnya nih. This approach is based on the on markets superior understanding of the problem product solve, the benefit it offers, or the issue it addresses, regardless of geography. Sebenarnya aku juga not really understand about this. We can discuss with Indah also. Tapi yang aku dapat dari buku seperti ini, setelah aku menyimpulkan yang beberapa poin dari buku. Okay, next, there is current segment size and growth potential. Is the market segment currently large enough to present a company with the opportunity to make a profit? Consider the following facts about India. Jadi kita bisa lihat nih, India itu, yang pertama tuh, India is the world fastest growing cell phone market. Wow. The industry is expanding at an annual rate of 50% with 5 to 6 million new subscriber added every month. Jadi itu berarti dia di India itu cell phone marketnya tuh bagus banget, dia fastest growing. Nah, terus yang kedua ini, about 1.3 million cars are sold each year in India. In absolute terms, this is a relatively small number. Tapi di India itu, kita dari data yang kita tahu, untuk penjualan apa mobil tuh small number, jadi kayak sedikit gitu kan. Terus ini fun fact yang kedua, yang ketiga tuh, approximately 70% of India's population is under the age of 35. This segment is increasingly affluent, and today young brand conscious consumers are buying apa nih, $100 Tommy Hilfiger jeans and berapa nih, $690 Louis Vuitton handbags. Wow, aku nggak tahu itu bagus atau enggak. Let's see the next. So, untuk assessing market potential and choosing target markets or segment tuh ada juga tentang potential competition. Jadi kita harus perhatiin ini. A market segment or country market characterized by strong competition may be a segment to avoid. However, if the competition is vulnerable in terms of price or quality disadvantage, it is possible for a market newcomer to make significant inroads.
over the past several decades, for example, Japanese companies in a variety of industry targeted the US market despite the presence of entrenched domestic market leaders. Okay, then next. So this is the framework for selecting target market. Jadi ini kita udah masuk ke target market ya. The first one is, what are the key drivers of these marketing models? Then, are enabling condition in place for this marketing model? What is the cost of entry? What is the cost of waiting? Is there risk or control trade-off appropriate? Jadi tuh lebih ke kayak kamu tuh ngevaluasi gitu kan. Kayak misalnya nih, yang the second one nih, are enabling condition in a place for this marketing model? Apa di tempat ini tuh cocok apa enggak sih dengan marketing model yang seperti ini? Terus, what is the cost of entry? And then what is the cost of waiting? Jadi tuh bagaimana dengan apa yang cost buat entry-nya, apa worth it atau enggak? What is the cost of waiting-nya tuh apa aja gitu kan? Terus is the risk control trade-off appropriate? Apa yang resikonya tuh kayak sebanding atau enggak? Jadi pokoknya di bagian targeting ini tuh we have to evaluate after we segmenting the market. Nah, gitu dengan beberapa pertanyaan-pertanyaan seperti ini. Oke, untuk product market decision. Nah, ada tuh yang namanya standardized global marketing. Standardized global marketing is analogous to mass marketing in a single country. It involves creating the same marketing mix for broad mass market of potential buyers. Standardized global marketing, also known as undifferentiated target marketing, is based on the premise that mass market exists around the world. Okay. And then, targeting is also the strategy employed by the hidden champion of global marketing. Companies are known to most people that have succeeded by serving a niche market that exists in many countries. Okay, and there is differentiated global marketing also. The third target market strategy, differentiated global marketing, represent a more ambitious approach than concentrated target market, also known as multi-segment targeting. This approach entails targeting two or more distinct market segment with multiple marketing mix. Jadi tuh ini poinnya aku ambil dari buku, tapi sisanya aku jelasin sendiri ya teman-teman semua. And then, attribute or benefit. Dari positioning itu sendiri, ini kita udah masuk positioning ya. Attribute or benefit. A frequently used position strategy exploit a particular product, attribute, benefit, or feature. Economic reliability and durability are frequently used attribute or benefit position. Volk automobiles are known for solid construction that offer safety in the event of crash. And then quality and price. This is important, guys. This strategy can be thought of in terms of a continuum for high fashion or quality and high price to good value, or rather than low quality at a reasonable price. User. Another positioning strategy represents how a product is used or associate the brand with user or class of users. Then competition, implicit or explicit reference to competitors can provide the basis for an effective positioning strategy. Nah, global, foreign, and local consumer culture positioning. Global Consumer Culture Positioning, or GCCP, is defined as a strategy that identifies a brand as a symbol of particular global culture or segment. And you can read here, for example, Sony brightly color at my first Sony in line. Line is positioned as the electronics brand for youngsters around the globe with discerning parents. Okay, thank you. That's all for my presentation. Let's discuss together.